Are you a SQL developer? You'll love this episode where you'll learn 7 tips in 7 minutes and even a couple more tips this week on Data Exposed MVP Edition. Hi, I'm Anna Hoffman, and welcome to this episode of Data Exposed MVP Edition. Today, I have Ike Ellis, or Ike on the mic, joining us today. And Ike, can you kick us off by telling us a little bit about what you do?
Sure. I'm a Microsoft MVP and have been for over 10 years. I'm the general manager of the data and AI practice at Soliance. I lead a team of 40 data engineers, data architects, data scientists, data analysts, and Power BI experts. And we love delivering data solutions, mostly analytical data solutions, but also large-scale transactional systems. We just love data. We work with data all day.
Awesome. I can definitely relate to that, and so can our viewers. Today, we have a super exciting episode planned because you're going to show us 7 tips in 7 minutes for the SQL developer. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to start a countdown on my side, and we'll just go through everything you get through. I'll give you like a 1-minute warning if we get to that, and maybe we'll have time for some questions at the end. So with that, I'm going to start it and pass it over to you, Ike.
Okay, great. So I assume a little bit about you. I assume that you are a SQL developer, that you probably know other languages like .NET or JavaScript, TypeScript, that you work in SQL because you're pulling data back and forth a little bit, and that you want to be better at using your tools. So some of these tips you might already know, some of them you might not, but stick around. I hope you learned something. So the first thing that I love is the splitter bar in SSMS, because it allows us to look at massive amounts of code, you know, and scroll through them differently. So that allows us to, the problem with transact SQL is transact SQL has this pattern where we declare a bunch of variables up at the top, and then later on we use them, right? Right. So the problem is that the farther away the usage is from the declaration, you kind of lose your space. So the splitter bar lets you look at the declaration and a bunch of parameters at the top and the call, and then it lets you navigate to where the usage is. It's really easy. That splitter bar is very, very useful. That's one tip I have. Another tip I have is once you create, if you've been working in SSMS or Azure Data Studio for a long time, you probably get into tab hell, where you just keep opening tabs, right? Well, the middle mouse button, you can't tell, but I'm clicking the middle mouse button, closes that window.
What?
So, yeah, you don't have to hit the X. You can just middle mouse button and close. Now, here's another tip. So I'm in a database. Let's say that I'm in this database and I'm looking at a whole bunch of tables here, right? So let's pretend that I've got, let me pick up a good query. This query is a good one, okay? Let's pretend that I've got a whole bunch of complicated queries here, and I don't really understand the table. So I can't tell you how often I've seen somebody take a table name out, add it to the bottom, and do what? They select count, and then they select. I've seen developers type this over and over. They run both those. And then now what are they doing here? They're profiling the data, right? They're trying to like, how many rows are in this thing before I go hog wild on it and show me what the data looks like real quick, right? Well, you type that so often, you don't really need to type that over and over. What you can do is you can go to tools, options. You can go into the environment, keyboard, and under here you have something called a query shortcut. Now, a lot of you might have used this for SPWHO and SPLOCK. That comes with SSMS. But for Control 3 here, I typed this as Control 3 and Control 4. So again, I went under environment, keyboard, keyboard shortcut, and I typed that in and I left the table off. What did that allow me to do? If I highlight something in a query that I'm looking at and I hit Control 3, it tells me the record count.
Wow.
I hit Control 4 and it gives me a top 100 and it shows me real quick what that table looks like. So no reason to keep typing that out as you profile data. Is that helpful?
Super helpful. I'm going to use it all the time.
Okay, good. Now, another thing that happens frequently is that people are on the wrong database often. Like they start typing and they're in the master database, right? And so I see them put their hands on the mouse and switch databases, right? But you don't really need to do that. What you can do instead is control U, can you see that it's highlighted up in my upper left corner? And then I can type in, you know, whichever one I care about, let's say master, and I hit enter. And what that does is it puts me at the exact part of my query that I was in before I hit control U. So the problem with the mouse is you're just clicking back and forth and you're taking yourself out of your flow, your stream of consciousness. So just control U, use the database, type it in, and then enter, and you're right back where you were before. So use your keyboard shortcuts. They're really, really helpful. Here's another tip. So this status bar down here at the bottom in SSMS gives you all kinds of useful information, particularly if you're working with Azure, because it tells you what Azure SQL database you're connected to, the master database, how many rows you have. I really like to see that at eye level, and I stand at a standing desk. So what I like to do is go to Tools, Options, and then underneath Projects and Solution, Text Editor, actually, Editor tab and status bar, I make the status bar go to the top. Now, it doesn't immediately work. You have to open up a new window. So if I open up a new query window, there it is at the top at eye level where I can see it. So I'm not craning my neck at the bottom all the time. Another thing I like to do is I don't like the beige color. So I try to make it something a little bit better, a little bit more vibrant. So I typically change it to something like a brighter green, like a light green. It's easier for me to look at. Again, it doesn't apply immediately. It's all new query windows get that. Speaking of bars, by the way, let's say that I have this is production, right? Now let's say that over here, this is a test server. Okay, I'm being honest with you, I have made the mistake where I thought I was in a test server when really I was in a production server. That is a very scary thing to be if you're doing CRUD, if you're doing updates, deletes, inserts, things like that. What you can do is on your connection, let me go ahead and reconnect. Here's my connection, right? If I go to options, what I can do is use a custom color and click OK and click connect. Okay, now when I have a new query window, there it is, red. Okay, so you can imagine if I have four or five databases underneath Object Explorer, and some of them are dev and some of them are production, I can change the query color so that my dev servers are green and my production servers are red. Couple that with putting the status bar up at the top, and now I've got a big red line to warn me that I'm on a production server before I do, you know, really important operations, right? For me, though, I'm going to go back to green because I don't need the warning right now. So let me go back. We'll go back to that green. Click connect. And now I'm back to green. New query. And I'm good. Okay. Look, all those empty windows, middle mouse button. I'm just closing them all. All right. All right. That's pretty neat. So here's another tip that you might find useful. So
you got just a couple seconds left, Ike.
I've already gone through 7 minutes.
Yeah, just
that's
about.
That's crazy. Okay, real quick, here I go. Here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to drag a table over, right? You guys have done this before. Let's go to the right database, T-SQL version 6. Oh, no, was I in there? I thought I was. Oh, from. What am I thinking? I really want to get to this one because this I'm going to go over. It's so sad.
I mean, these are amazing. Let's see.
Okay. So here is me pulling a table over. In fact, let me pull a different one over. I'm going to pull customers over. So you guys knew that in Object Explorer, you could drag, drop something. There's customers, right? Okay. Now, the other thing you might not know is you can drag the whole column list over. So if you open up the customers database, grab columns, and boop, you get all the columns over. Okay. There's all the columns. Now, another thing that you can do is you can use a SQL prettifier. So you could Google SQL prettifier. They're pretty easy to find. The one I like is Instant SQL Pro Formatter. Paste it, right? And then you just prettify, and you get the prettified version right here. So let me go back to SSMS, paste, execute. And now this is the prettified version. Oh, let me switch databases, sorry. I'll do it again. Oh, there it is. Okay, boop, boop, boop. Okay. All right, prettified version. So using a prettifier really helps you with your code formatting. Now here's the problem, and this is one of my favorite tips. Let's say that I wanted to join another table, sales order header, H. On c.customerid equals h.customerid, okay? If I do this, I get this error, ambiguous column name. Now, I'm sure you guys don't get that error, but I get that error all the time. How do I fix that? Well, when I joined the other table, these columns were in both tables. I aliased this one as a C. Now, what I watch people do all the time is this, C dot, and then they come over here, yep. C dot, right? We don't need to do that. What we can do instead is this. We've got the prettified version. We do Alt Shift. I'm hitting Alt Shift. I'm hitting my down arrow. And then all at once, C dot. Now I hit F5 and it works.
Wow.
Okay. So did I give 7 tips? I think I did.
I think you gave quite a few tips. And honestly, I didn't know about most of these things. And I'm kind of a SQL noob, but it's still pretty exciting. So I think, you know, I thank so much. This has been really exciting to see all these tips. Folks should maybe follow Ike on the mic to learn more about tips like this and other things. To our viewers, thanks so much for joining us. If you like this episode, go ahead and give it a like, leave us a comment and let us know your favorite tip or if you have other tips for other viewers. And we hope to see you next time on Data Exposed.